GraphQL is a huge thing when it comes to optimizing the way you get your data into the application. That is why it's available in Umbraco Heartcore. And today, I will show you where to find the GraphQL playground and how to build queries. My name is Jakob, let my voice guide you through this journey. You can find GraphQL playground on your headers project when you log into the backoffice and navigate to the settings section. From there, find the headers tree near the bottom of the navigation list and click on GraphQL playground. And from here, you can start building queries as soon as your content is published. To help you with that, you have access to built-in documentation, which you can find on the right side under Docs tab. The documentation tab grants a quick overview of how content is structured using the document types in your solution. It also gives you an idea on how to access specific properties on each of the document types, as well as nested properties and properties from compositions. The documentation will be automatically updated as you add new document types to match the schema you have on your project. Speaking of schema, if you want to get an overview of that, the tab can be found on the right side of GraphQL Playground. It is located below the Docs tab in its own little section and will be updated automatically as you make changes to the project's schema, meaning document types, data types, document type compositions, and document type elements. You can type your queries on the left side of the GraphQL playground. Could be something as basic as getting the names of all your content pages, which I would do like this. And then press the play looking button over here to get the data. GraphQL Playground also supports requests made with HTTP headers, in case an authorization token is needed, for example. The HTTP headers section can be accessed from the bottom left corner of the Playground window. By default, it contains the UMB project alias header, which is the alias of your hardcore project. It is of course possible to add multiple headers. You can also define variables if you like, just like this. You can also prettify your queries to make them easier to look at. That was an introduction to the GraphQL Playground. I hope that knowledge helps you build your new awesome site. Thank you for watching and have a fantastic day.